Hello all, and welcome to this AWS tutorial on mounting EFS on EC2 instances using EFS mount helper. Before we go further ahead with the demo, let us review a couple of things about EFS. Amazon's Elastic File System is a fully managed, shared cloud file storage service that is scalable in nature. It is designed to provide massively parallel shared access to thousands of Amazon EC2 instances. It is a regional service, and when mounted on Amazon EC2 instances, an Amazon EFS file system provides a standard file system interface. Multiple Amazon EC2 instances can access an Amazon EFS file system at the same time, making it a common data source. So essentially, all of these points suggest the fact that it is something which is very similar to a shared folder or a shared folder on a network drive, or something very similar to that. You can mount EFS using EFS helper or NFS utils directly. In this particular tutorial, we will use EFS mount helper to mount EFS on Amazon's Linux EC2 instances. EFS mount helper automatically uses certain NFS utils mount options that are optimized for Amazon's EFS. So what this particular point suggests essentially is that EFS mount helper behind the scenes uses NFS utils to basically mount Amazon EFS on EC2 instances. It's just that EFS mount helper has been programmed or with certain NFS utils mount options that are optimized or ideal for Amazon's EFS overall. So I have actually listed all the options over here. Now you will see when we perform the demo that all these options are generally encapsulated. So when we mount EFS on our EC2 instances, you will not see all these options because EFS helper has actually encapsulated them. But behind the scenes, these are the values or these are the options that EFS mount helper is using to basically mount EFS on EC2 instances. So let us review these options. So the first option is NFS version. So by default over here, EFS mount helper uses the NFS version 4.1. Now, typically otherwise, let's say you could use 2 or 3, but for Amazon EC2 Linux instances and using Amazon EFS, it typically uses version 4.1. The next option over here is the read size. So this is basically the maximum number of bytes in each network read request. And after that is the W size, which is the write size. And that is obviously the maximum number of bytes per network write request. The fourth option over here, as we see, is whether this is going to be a hard mount or whether this is going to be a soft mount. Now, by default, obviously EFS mount helper uses hard mount, but let's say if you were doing NFS utils or you are basically mounting this using NFS utils, then you could potentially use a soft mount as well. The fifth option over here is time O, which is nothing else but timeout. And the value over here that is specified 600, that is in deciseconds. So 60 seconds is equal to 600 deciseconds. So that typically tells us that the timeout is 1 minute. The next option after that is retrans, which is nothing else but the number of times the NFS client tries to retry. So basically this is the number of times it is going to try to connect again or send the request again, which is basically set to 2. The next option after that is no RESV port, which is no reserved port. And this basically is when the NFS client communicates with your NFS server, is it supposed to communicate over a privileged source port? Yes or no. So let's say if you had, instead of no RSV port, you had only mentioned RSV port, and then the port number, then it would communicate only on that specific port. But if you specify no RSEV port, then this particular option allows the client to connect using a non-privileged source port. So it will pretty much pick up any TCP port that is available to communicate to NFS server. And the last option over here, underscore net dev, this option prevents the client from attempting to mount the file system until the network has been enabled. So these are the options by default that EFS mount helper uses to basically mount Amazon EFS on Amazon EC2 instances. Okay, so the next thing that we will do is we will review through the architectural diagram. So as you see, we have an Amazon region right here. And within this region, we have created a VPC over here with the CIDR block 172.16.0.0/16. And in this VPC, we have a public subnet with the CIDR block 172.16.0.0/24. In this particular subnet, which is a public subnet, and the reason why this is a public subnet is because it is attached to an internet gateway. As you see, we have an internet gateway right here. So, and in this public subnet, we will be launching a bunch of EC2 instances with public IP enabled. Now, if you see over here to the right, we have the Elastic File System. And as you see, if you remember, we had mentioned earlier in the second slide that Elastic File System is a regional resource. So basically it's available at a regional level. And when we actually provision this Elastic File System in this demo, you will see that there are mount targets for each availability zone and each subnet. So basically this is a regional resource, and that's hence it has been shown over here. And we will be mounting it when we go ahead with and associating it with our availability zone and our public subnet, thereby providing access to all the EC2 instances which are there in that subnet. So any EC2 instance that has the capability of basically mounting this Elastic File System. Okay, so these are the steps essentially. The first step over here, as you see, is to create the VPC with one subnet and attach internet gateway, thereby making it public. And then modify the VPC's route table to basically add or associate the subnet and also add the route going to internet gateway. Now, the reason why these two steps are in green is because in order to speed up the demo, I've basically created the VPC and added a subnet to it and attached an internet gateway and modified the VPC's route table to add the subnet and an outgoing route to internet gateway. So we will basically continue from step three and go further ahead. So the first thing that we will do is we will provision two Amazon Linux EC2 instances, and then we will obviously, while we are creating or launching our EC2 instances, we will basically create a security group for EC2, and we will enable port 22 for SSH. Next thing that we will do is we will create a security group for EFS and enable inbound port 2049 for NFS. Finally, we will provision our EFS and attach it to our VPC. And then we will go ahead and mount our EFS on both our Linux EC2 instances using EFS helper. And finally, we will create a test file as a shared resource, just to basically showcase that the whole idea over here is to, you know, that one EC2 instance creates a file on EFS, but the other EC2 instance can easily read it. So let's go ahead and launch a couple of EC2 instances. So I'll switch to my Amazon account right here, and I'll switch to my mouse now. So let's launch EC2 instances. So I launched the first one now. So I'm going to use free tier and I'm going to use Amazon Linux right here. Select. Next. And this should be in my VPC. My VPC is VPCA. And it has one public subnet as you see. And we are going to enable public IP. And then I'll leave rest of the other settings as default. Click on next. I'm going to leave this as default as well. Click on next. Okay, let's add a tag here. I'm going to say name and I'm going to give this a name as blue. And we'll create a new security group as we discussed in our steps right here. So as you see, these are the steps. So we'll create a new security group and enable port 22. So let's create a security group over here. We're going to say EC2-SG. And I'm going to copy the same thing over here. And as you see, our SSH port 22 is enabled. So let's go ahead and click on launch. And I'm going to use my default, the pair that I have, that I generally use for my demos for this particular EC2 instance as well. So let's click on launch instances. And there is our instance right there. So our instance blue, one of our instances has been launched. So let's go ahead and launch another instance. And we will again select free tier. It's going to be a Linux instance again. T2 micro. And this is again going to be in my VPCA, public subnet. I'm going to enable public IP for this. Click on add storage. Again, yes. And this time I'm going to give it the name as, I'm going to give it the name as green. I'm going to reuse the same security group here. So I'm going to reuse this group and it has port 22 enabled. Click on review and launch and then launch. We'll use the same key pair and click on launch instances. So as you see, my second EC2 instance has also been created. It's right here. So I'm going to remove the filter so you can see both the instances. So as you see, both the instances have been provisioned. So we'll give it some time to provision the green instance. And in the meantime, we will go ahead and create a security group for our EFS. So let's create a new security group right here. And I'm going to give this a name as EFS SG. We'll keep the same as description. Again, attach it to my VPC. And I'm going to add over here or inbound rule for NFS. So if you scroll down right here, here is NFS. And as you see, port 2049 is enabled. And we can basically give access to our EC2 group over here and click on create. So basically what we have done is we have provisioned two Amazon Linux instances. We have created the security group for EC2. We've also created the security group for EFS and enabled inbound port 2049 for NFS. So the next thing that we will do now is we will provision EFS. So let me go ahead and select EFS. So we will go ahead and create our file system now. So I'm going to select my VPC as my VPCA. And as you see, I only have one availability zone, one subnet right there. And by default, it is taking the default security group for this VPC. So I'm going to go to and remove this. And I'm going to go and add, oops, it became really small now. Okay. This is a bug, but this is my security group right here. So there you see. Okay, so this is the EC2 security group, which is the wrong one. So let's go ahead and select EFS. Okay, so I'm going to remove the EC2 security group and let the EFS security group stay in here. Then click on next. And as you see, these are the options. Now we have a couple of options over here. First, we have the performance mode as general purpose or max IO. General purpose is basically any regular file system. So as I mentioned over here as well, right? We recommend general purpose for most of the file systems, whereas max IO performance mode is optimized for applications where tens and hundreds and thousands of EC2 instances are accessing the file system at the same time. So basically, it kind of, you know, scales the aggregate throughput and operations per second. But as you see, it mentions over here that there is a trade-off of slightly higher latencies for file operations. So since we do not have hundreds and thousands of EC2 instances, we will be using general purpose and for our performance mode. And for our throughput mode, as you see, there are two over here. One is bursting and one is provision. So bursting essentially is the fact that as the file system grows, the throughput will grow. That means it will increase depending upon the size of the file system, increase or decrease. So it will basically set itself. But let's say if I wanted to click on provision, then I will have to specify over here that at any given point of time, irrespective of the storage and the size of the file system, this is the amount of throughput that I want. Okay, I'll definitely recommend you to click on this learn more link over here. Okay, so if you click on this link and go, I want to showcase something to you. So if you scroll further down, here is, so this table is really very helpful. So you, this actually helps you to understand how the bursting behavior actually works. So as you see, this is a table, I'm highlighting it to you over here. So if the file system size is 100 gigabytes, then it'll burst to about 100 MIBs over here. And you know, if it's 1 terabyte, then it's 100 MIBs, but then it's for at least 12 hours a day. Here it's only 72 minutes. If it is 10 TB, then it goes all the way up to 1 GB for 12 hours a day. And generally anything larger, then it will go to 100 MIBs per TIB, as you see over here, for 12 hours each and every day. So as you see, this is how it kind of, you know, depending upon the size of the file system, it basically, you know, sets the throughput accordingly. Okay, so let me go back now to my interface. I'm going to basically, we will use bursting for our demo today. So I'm going to switch back to bursting and then click on next step. And as you see, this is a summary of everything that we have selected so far. And then let us click on create file system. So this should provision the file system shortly. So there is a file system. As you see, it was created successfully. And another thing that you want to keep, make a note of is the file system ID. It's right here. And if you don't want to use the file system ID, the other thing that you can always use, and typically Amazon also recommends, is to use the entire DNS name, which is right here where it's mentioned. Okay, so we had created two EC2 instances over here, and how to go about mounting EFS on EC2 instances. The instructions are right here. So let's click on that. And we will basically be following these EC2, these steps to basically mount EFS on our EC2 instances. So as you see, basically it gives you all the steps as to how to set up your EC2 instance and how to go about mounting EFS using EFS helper. So obviously one of the first things that we will do is, if you're using Amazon Linux EC2 instance, which we are, then the first thing that we will do is we will install EFS mount helper. And this is the command for that. And once we have installed EFS mount helper, the next thing that we will do is basically we will create a directory, typically called as a mount directory over here. So basically the name of this directory is going to be EFS. And after we have created a directory, finally we will use EFS mount helper to basically mount our file system and on this directory right here. So this is the command for that. And then finally this EFS file system should be available to our EC2 to basically create any files. So the access should be available and it should be successfully mounted. Okay, so let me kind of close this temporarily right now and go back to my EC2. So this is my EC2 right here. And what I'm going to do is I am going to connect an SSH session to our EC2 instances. So I'm going to grab the public IP addresses. So let us first see our blue instance. So this is our blue instance right here. And this is the IP address. I'm going to copy the IP address and then I'm going to use PuTTY to connect. So I'm going to copy the IP address. I'm going to increase the font so that you can see easily. And then since this is a blue instance, I'm going to change the background to blue. Okay, so that way we can differentiate between the instances. And I'm going to change the foreground to white. There you go. Okay, so let's, the next thing that we need to do is select our private keys. This is my private key and click on open. So this is a blue instance coming up. As you see, it's connecting. And this is EC2 user. Click enter and there we are. We are connected to our blue instance. Okay, so this is our blue instance right there. The next thing that we are going to do is we are going to connect to our green instance. So let's click on green instance. Again, I'm going to enable a PuTTY session for that. Copy the address, change the font size. And for this one, I'm going to change the background to green. So we know that this is the green EC2 instance. And foreground to white, so you should be able to read it clearly. And then select our private key file right there. Click on open. So now this is our green. Click yes and EC2-user. And there we are connected to our EC2 green EC2 instance. So we have both our EC2 instances connected. So the next thing now we need to do is install EFS helper on both of them. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to go back over here and we are going to follow the same steps that Amazon has suggested. So let us go ahead and first install our EFS mount helper. So I'm going to copy this and we will first install this on blue instance. So let's go to blue. So I'm going to change to the root user. So this is the command for that, sudo su. And then let's go ahead and install EFS mount helper. So as you see, it's installing, so it's installed. The next thing that we will do after we have installed this is we will create our directory. So this is our directory right here. So let's copy that. And this is going to create that directory. So as you see, a directory has been created. And after we have created a directory, we will now mount it. So this is the command to mount it using EFS mount helper. So copy the command. I'm just going to clear this and copy that right here. So as you see, it's mounting our file system. This is the file system ID. And this is our directory that we just created. So hit enter. And it should be mounted shortly. So there it is. Our file system has been mounted. So let's verify that. So say cd EFS. So this, we've changed our directory. And now we will go ahead and I'll create a temporary file over here, index.or maybe let's say nam.txt, or let's just make it, you know, blue.txt. This is better. Okay, hit enter and say this file was created by EC2 blue. Okay, let's go ahead and save the file. So hit escape, control, WQ, and hit enter. So we have created this file on the network, on the Elastic File System, using a blue EC2 instance. Now let's switch to our green instance and we'll follow the same steps again. So the first thing that we will do is we will install EFS mount helper. So let's do that. Before we do that, we need to switch to the root user. So sudo su, and let's copy the command here and install EFS mount helper. So hit enter over here. Okay, so after we have installed EFS mount helper, the next thing that we will do is again create the directory on our green instance. So let's create the directory, and our directory is created. And the next thing that we will do is we will mount our EFS. So let's copy the command for that. So this is the command. I'm going to clear the screen again and copy it right here. As you see, this is our file system ID. This is our directory where it will be mounted. And let's hit on enter. So as you see, our Elastic File System has been mounted successfully on the green instance. Let us verify that. So I'm going to do cd EFS and change my directory. Now remember, from our blue instance, we had actually created blue.txt. Now if this is truly on EFS, we should be able to see this file from a green instance. So let us verify that. So let us do ls minus l, and this should show us the blue.txt. So as you see, we can see blue.txt right here. If you want, you can even go inside and take a look at it. So there it is. This is blue.txt. Okay. And if you want, we can modify this. Okay, so I'm going to say, I'm just going to type in, let's say modified by green. Escape and save the file. And there it is. So we modified our blue.txt. Let us create a new file, green.txt. Okay. And I'm going to say over here, this file was created by EC2 green. And let us save the file. And there it is. So now if I go back to my blue instance and I do ls minus L, I should be able to see both blue and green TXTs. So as you see, I can see both the files right here. And now if I want, I can basically modify green.txt from right here and basically say this was modified by blue EC2 and save it right here. There it is. So we basically created two different files from two different EC2 instances. Both these files are created on EFS. And as you see, both these instances are connected to EFS and they can see these files. And they can actually, they have read and write access to it, and they can modify the files as required. So this way, basically, you can leverage EFS as a common or a shared file system or a common data source to basically store your files. And right now we have only two EC2 instances, but you could potentially have several, like thousands of EC2 instances that can actually share this network resource and have their files and basically also share files amongst themselves, just like how we did right now. So let us do one last thing. Here is blue.txt, and as you see, you can see the modification. And if I come over here and say vim green.txt, you can see that this was modified by EC2 blue. So finally, just to put both of them together right here. And there you go. So we have successfully mounted EFS on two EC2 instances, created two shared files that were created by two instances independently, and then were modified by each other. So hopefully this was helpful and this gave you a good understanding about EFS and potentially how you could use EFS and what EFS is. Please post your comments or provide any feedback. If you would like me to create a video on any specific topic, then do let me know. If you like this video, please click on like. And if you would like to know whenever I, publish a new video, please subscribe to my channel so you'll be the first one to know when the video is launched. So thank you all and have a nice day. Thank you. Bye-bye.